Welcome to a lesson on how to determine the remaining loan balance after a certain number of years using the loan formula. With loans, it is often desirable to determine what the remaining loan balance will be after some number of years. For example, if you purchase a home and plan to sell it in 5 years, you might want to know how much of the loan balance you will have paid off and how much you have to pay from the sale. To determine the remaining loan balance after a number of years, we first need to know the loan payment if we don't already know. Remember that only a portion of a loan payment goes toward the loan balance. A portion also goes toward the loan interest. For example, if your payments were $1,000 a month, after a year, you will not have paid off $12,000 of the loan balance. To determine the remaining loan balance, we can think how much loan will these loan payments be able to pay off in the remaining time of the loan. So here's our loan formula, which we should already be familiar with. P sub 0 is the loan amount, D is the loan payment per unit of time, R is the annual interest rate as a decimal, K is the number of compounds per year, and N is the length of the loan in years. So let's consider a car loan example. You purchase a new car for $20,000 using a loan with monthly payments for 5 years at 4% interest. What will the remaining balance be after 3 years? So often when answering this type of problem, there are two steps. Number one, we calculate the monthly payments on the loan, and then two, calculate the remaining loan balance based on the remaining time of the loan. So it does seem a bit strange that if this was your new car, you wouldn't know the car payments, but in either case, we'll begin by determining what the monthly payment would be. Let's begin by identifying the given information. The original loan balance is $20,000, so P sub 0 equals $20,000. The payments are monthly, so we'll assume monthly compounded interest, and therefore K is equal to 12. The loan is for 5 years, so N equals 5. The interest is 4%, so R as a decimal would be 0.04, and we're trying to find the monthly payment, which would be D. And now we'll sub these values into the formula. So again, we've done this before, but P sub 0 is equal to 20,000. R is equal to 0.04. N is equal to 5, and K is equal to 12. So K appears 3 times. Now we want to solve this for D, so we'll simplify inside the parentheses in the numerator, then the denominator, and then solve for D. So in the numerator we'd have 1 minus the quantity 1 plus 0.04 divided by 12. We're going to raise this to the power of negative 60. We do have to be careful when rounding. If we do want to round, we should include at least 3 significant digits, but notice in this case I'm going to include all decimal places, which we see here. And our denominator is 0.04 divided by 12, which gives us this decimal here. Again, if we do round, it is going to change the answer slightly. Now because we still have this D here, we'll find this quotient, then multiply by D, therefore this quotient will give us this coefficient which we see here. So if we take 0.1809968963 and divide by 0.00 followed by 8 threes, it gives us this value here, which again is the coefficient of D. And that is all for D. We divide both sides by this value. So on the right side, we just have D, and this quotient will give us the monthly payment. So we have 20,000 divided by 54.2990693. Run into the nearest cent, Notice how the monthly payment is $368.33. Now we can answer the question, what will the remaining balance be after 3 years? Well, after 3 years, notice how, because it's a 5-year loan, there's only 2 years remaining. So we'll be making these payments here for 2 more years, which means we now want to find P sub 0, the loan amount, again with 2 years remaining. So R is still 0.04, N is now 2 years, K is still 12, and now we know the monthly payment is $368.33. So again, performing substitution into our loan formula, notice R is 0.04, N is 2, K is 12, and D is 368.33. Notice here we're solving for P sub 0, which means we just need to simplify the right side here. And again, we'll do this in steps. So looking at the numerator in the parentheses, we'd have 1 minus the quantity 1 plus 0.04 divided by 12. We're now going to raise this to the power of negative 24, which gives us this decimal here. And our denominator is the same as last time, which we see here. So now we'll find the product of the numerator and then divide by the denominator. So let's put the numerator in parentheses. We'd have 368.33 times 0.076768361. Close parenthesis, and then we'll divide by 0.00 followed by 83s. Enter. Now notice here, if we round to the nearest cent, we would actually round up, and therefore 99 cents rounds to a dollar, and therefore the remaining loan balance after 3 years would be $8,482. Which means if you wanted to sell your car after 3 years, you'd want to make sure you sell the car for more than this amount, otherwise you would still owe on the loan. I hope you found this helpful.